Jnana Tamarandasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chaksurun Militan Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Nama Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Pristaya Bhutale Srimati Bhaktivedanta Swaminiti Namane Namaste Sarasati Devi Gauravani Pracharine Nirvisesha Shanyavadi Paschacya Deshatarine Vanchakaupatarubhyascha Kripa Sindhu Bhayevacha Patitanam Favanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So we're hearing the Brihad Bhagavatamrita, a book written by Srila Sanatana Goswami, describing about a devotee who traveled to the spiritual world. And he learned about the glories of Vrindavan and how the people of Vrindavan, the residents of Vrindavan, are actually residents of, they're non-different from the residents of the spiritual world. So Maharaj Parikshit was reciting this story to his mother, Uttara, and he wanted to impress on his mother the wonderful position of Vrindavan and the people of Vrindavan.
Maharaj Parikshit 大君就向Uttara 他的母亲背诵了这个这本书，他就荣耀了文达本和文达本居民的地位。
So he's reciting, Maharaj Parikshit was reciting some verses from the 10th canto Srimad Bhagavatam, where Lord Brahma was offering prayers to Lord Krishna.
现在呢, Parikshit 大君正在向他母亲 Uttara 背诵圣典薄伽瓦坛第十篇的一些诗节。
And in these prayers, Lord Brahma is glorifying the position of Vrindavan and the people of Vrindavan.
这些诗节是主 Brahma 向主 Krishna 献上的祈祷，他歌颂了温达文的荣耀，歌颂了温达文居民的荣耀。
So, this is one of the prayers offered by Lord Brahma. He's telling Lord Krishna that until people become your devotees, their material attachments are just like plunderers, like thieves.
主Brahma告诉Krishna，直到一个人成为您的奉献者之前，他的物质欲望，他的物质依附，就好像那些掠夺者，就好像那些盗贼一般。
And their homes are just like a prison.
他们的家就好比监狱。
And the affection which they have for their family are just like chains on their feet, which keep them in one position.
他们对家庭的依恋和对家庭的爱恋，就好像他们的足靠，脚上的铁锁，就把他们固定在一个地方。
So in this prayer, Lord Brahma is responding to a question which Krishna might ask him.
在这个祈祷文当中，主 Brahma 就回复了主 Krishna 可能向他提出的一个问题。
Krishna might say to Brahma, "Now, why do you think the Brijbasi people can get more from Krishna than people like sannyasis? Because sannyasis, they've given up everything."
Brahma 可能会向主 Krishna 可能会问 Brahma, 为什么这些 Brijbasi 居民们他们从 Krishna 那里获得的比那些已经放弃了一切物质依附的 sannyasi 托钵僧们得到的回报更多呢？
So these sannyasis, they've got rid of all the material contamination and they're left with Krishna. So why shouldn't the Brijbasi people also be happy by having Krishna?
这些 sannyasi 托钵僧们，他们就像 Krishna 那样，已经去除了一切物质污染。可是那些 Brijbasi 们，他们好像是更加快乐一般。
So Brahma answers by telling Krishna that these material desires are just like thieves.
在此 ，Brahma 就告诉我们，物质欲望就像小偷盗贼。
And because of these material attachments, they're not able to distinguish properly what is of value and what is not.
由于他们的物质依附，所以他们就无法分辨哪些是有价值的事物，而哪些是没有用途的事物。
And because of these attachments, they don't have any determination.
而且也是由于这些物质依附，他们做事情的时候是没有决心的。
And the homes in which they're living with their family, they're just like a prison because of the attachment which they have for them. They cannot escape from them.
他们生活，他们与家人一起生活的家，就像监狱一般。原因是因为他们是无法逃脱这样的地方。
But sannyasis, successful sannyasis, they avoid these things. They don't get caught in these things. They don't get caught in the prison of family life.
但是那些已经取得了成功的 sannyasi 托钵僧们，他们避免了这样的监狱，因为他们没有被陷在家庭生活当中。
But the Brijbasi people, they're more worthy of praise than these sannyasis.
可是 Brijbasi 的人们比这些托钵僧还更加值得称道。
These Brijbasi people, they have their homes, they have attachments and desires, and the love they have for their family members all free them from bondage.
These 托钵僧们，他们原本也是有各自的家庭，也有依附，还有欲望，还有家，但是他们都全部予以了放弃。
So Lord Brahma is arguing, he's saying that these Brijbasi people, they should get a greater reward for their worship of Krishna than these Mayavadi sannyasis.
Brahma, 主 Brahma 说，这些 Brijbasi 的人们，他们要比那些假象中的托钵僧们，他们从 Krishna 那里得到了更大的回报。
Yeah.These sannyasis who are not devotees, although they have some spiritual achievement, it's just like that of the demons killed by Krishna.
波僧们，他们，他们并非奉献者，所以他们取得的灵性成就，就和那些被 Krishna 所杀死的恶魔们取得的成就是一样的。
Yeah, these demons, they concentrate on Krishna, but they're trying to kill Krishna.
那些恶魔们，他们一心一意的，全心全意想着 Krishna， 但是动机是为了杀死 Krishna。
And when Krishna kills them, then they get to the Brahman, they get impersonal liberation.
当他们这些恶魔们为 Krishna 所杀死的时候，他们就进入了梵光，得到了非人格的解脱。
But there's a big difference between impersonal liberation and what the devotee, what the Vaishnavas get.
就是非人格的解脱和 Vaishnava 们取得的成就，二者有着天壤区别。
The devotees, the Vaishnavas, they actually enter into the spiritual kingdom, into the Vaikuntha, and they get the lotus feet of Krishna.
那些奉献者们，他们的目的地是他们的目的地到达的是 Vaikuntha， 到达了主 Krishna 的莲花组灵性的王国。
So this prayer of Brahma can be understood in different ways. And one way which we could understand it is we could think that Brahma is answering a doubt about the Brijbasis. That why? Because they're full of attachment and desires. So why give them more praise?
Brahma 的这个祈祷实际上可以以不同的方式被理解。主 Brahma 实际上就回应了一个疑惑，那这些 Vrajabasi 他们有着那么多的依附，有着那么多的欲望，可是为什么他们却受到了那么多的赞扬呢？
The Vaishnavas, they are renounced. They're renounced in their behavior and in their hearts they're renounced.So why should the Brijbasi people get more respect than them?
那些托钵僧们，他们的行为，他们的内心，比起 Brijbasi 来讲，他是更加气绝了。可是为什么 Brijbasi 他们得到的，受到人们这么大的赞美呢？
Krishna's devotees, they've learned about the value of devotional service.To him.
Krishna 的奉献者们，他们了解对 Krishna 奉献服务的价值所在。
And so they connect their devotional service, they connect their attachments to Krishna's service.
所以他们把他们的依附之心和对 Krishna 的奉献服务连接在一起。
But some sannyasis who are not devotees.They may be renounced, but it's no use because they have no attachment to Krishna.
有些 sannyasi, 有些并不是奉献者的托钵僧 sannyasi, 他们的气绝没有用，因为他们没有依附 Krishna.
They may do a lot of austerities, but the result.They'll simply become proud. They're not going to get devotion.
他们可能从事大量的苦行，但结果呢，却是使他们内心变得骄傲，他们缺乏奉爱之心。
But the desire of every devotee of Krishna, a devotee of Krishna, their desires are never satisfied.Because all of their desires are in relation to Krishna.
奉献者们的欲望，他们是永无厌足的，因为他们的欲望是跟 Krishna 有关的。
In the same way, the Brijbasi people are never satisfied. They never have enough of Krishna. They always want more Krishna.
同样的，那些 Brijbasi 人们 ，Brijbasi 的居民 ，Braj 的居民们，他们也是永无厌足的。他们想要更多、更多跟 Krishna 相关联的事物。
And another way to understand Brahma's prayers is that he's suggesting that the Brijbasi people are enjoying the loving exchange with Krishna.
Brahma 的这段祈祷当中呢，从中我们可以得到的另外一个启发就是说，这些 Braja 的居民们，他们享受着跟 Krishna 的爱的交流。
And Krishna is repaying them for their devotion.
而 Krishna 在回报着他们的奉爱之情。
But if someone doesn't become a devotee, if we never become a devotee, then we're always going to be in the bondage material life.
相反，一位非奉献者，非奉献者们，他们总是受到物质的束缚。
So Krishna has a more important reason for coming to this world. He didn't come here just to enjoy with his friends.
Krishna 来到这个物质世界不止一个原因，他不只是和他的朋友们在那里单纯的在享受。
He wants to attract everyone to devotional service.
Krishna 想要吸引每一个灵魂来从事奉爱服务。
So he doesn't perform his pastimes just for the pleasure of devotees.
所以 Krishna 他上演他的逍遥，不只是为了针对奉献者才上演他的逍遥。
So the Brijbasi people shouldn't think that his debt to them was repaid just because he plays with them.
So these Braj 的居民们，他们不应当这样想，仅仅是因为 Krishna 和他们玩耍了之后，然后他就回报了欠他们，对他们。他就偿还了欠他们的债务。
And another way to understand Brahma's prayer is that Krishna will always be anxious until everyone becomes his devotee.
从 Brahma 的这段祈祷文当中得到的另外一个启示就是，除非每一个灵魂都成为 Krishna 的奉献者，否则的话 ，Krishna 的焦虑还是没有完全的。解除。
And until everyone becomes a devotee, Krishna's attachments and desires will take away his peace of mind and mental equilibrium.
而且，除非每一个灵魂都成为了他的奉献者，否则的话 ，Krishna 的依附 ，Krishna 的欲望。就会把他的这个心意的平和拿走。
And his home in Vaikuntha will just be like a prison, because the company of those who live there with him will take away his freedom.
而且他在 Vaikuntha 的居所也将变成监狱，因为。他的在百昆特的那些同伴们就会把他的自由拿走。
And the affection which Lord Krishna has for people like the goddess of fortune and other people in Vaikuntha, they'll be like shackles on his feet, which will stop his freedom.
而且在百昆特的幸运女神还有其他人。对 Krishna 的爱就会像他脚上的足链铁链一样 把他的自由来拿走。
Yeah, he won't be able to enjoy the company of his very greatest devotees.
因为他就不能享受跟他的最伟大的奉献者们为伴的乐趣了。
But he'll feel the pain of separation.
他将内心感受到分离的痛楚。
So Brahma predicts, he says, after Krishna leaves the Vrijbasis to go to Mathura, then he will always feel separation from them.
Brahma 就预言，一旦主 Krishna 离开 Vrijbasis 去 Mathura， 他们将感受到最深厚的、最深的这种分离之情。
So then Brahma offers another prayer. Just a minute. Lord Brahma offers another prayer in which he says that he's praying to Krishna. He said, you have nothing to do with the material world.
现在 Brahma 就献上了另一段祈祷文，他对主 Krishna 祈祷说，您和物质世界是没有关系的。
You come to this world just to imitate material life.
您来此原因只不过是为了模仿物质生活而已。
And to expand the different ecstasies of your surrendered devotees.
并且去扩展您的不同的臣，已经臣服了您的灵魂，您的奉献者们的狂喜。
Right. So that's Brahma's prayer. So Krishna, he might say that he comes to Vrindavan not just to enjoy pastimes with his devotees, but also to become their relative.
以上是 Brahma 的祈祷，接下来 Krishna 他可能会表达说，他来到 Vrindavan 不仅仅是为了上演从事消时光，另外一个原因是为了成为他的奉献者们的亲戚。
So this way he's imitating the material life, and he wants to increase the ecstasy of the devotees.
他以这种方式模仿了物质生活，并且增加了他奉献者的狂喜。
But Brahma thinks that just pretending to be the son or a family member is not enough to repay the debt which Krishna has to the Vrindavan people.
充当他们的家人，还不足以来回报他欠那些 Braja 居民们的债务。
So Brahma is asking if Krishna becoming the son or the relative of the Vrijbasi people on earth, is it a fact?Is it a false show? Is it just illusion?
亲属们，难道这个是不是一种幻象呢？
So the answer to Brahma's question is no, it's not. that Krishna proves the seriousness of his intentions.
在回答 Brahma 的这个疑惑的时候呢，答案就是否定的。Krishna 这么做是实际上证明了他的目的的真纯。
Krishna comes to enlighten people, not to delude them, but to enlighten them.
Krishna 来此的目的是为了启迪人们，而不是使人们陷入幻觉。
Just like when Krishna shows his universal form to Mother Yashoda.
正如主 Krishna 向他的母亲 Yashoda 展示了宇宙形体。
Or sometimes he will reveal himself.As the Supreme Lord to the devotees.
或者有时候他会向他的奉献者们展示他作为至尊主的地位。
So anybody who comes in touch with Krishna, they get free of material delusion. They get enlightened.
任何跟 Krishna 取得接触的人都立即获得了灵性的启迪。摆脱了物质的幻象。
Krishna cannot hide his true nature from his devotee.
Krishna 不可能把他自己的真实的本性，从他的奉献者的那里掩盖起来。
So Krishna comes to this world to share with the devotees this ecstasy.
Krishna 来到世俗的世界。是为了向跟他的奉献者们来分享他的狂喜。
But when Krishna goes to other planets, like the heavenly planets, it's not the same.
一旦 Krishna 去了其他的星球，比如说天堂，就不一样了。
Just like when Krishna becomes Lord Vamanadeva and he becomes the son of Aditi, so.There's not the ecstasy as there is in Vrindavan.
就像 Krishna, 他成为了他成为 Vamanadeva, 做了 Aditi 的儿子，他的狂喜就和上述的狂喜就不一样。
Because there, in the heavenly planets, they're very much aware.They're too much aware of Krishna's position, that he's the supreme.
Because in the heaven, the people of heaven are aware of Krishna's position of Krishna's position. They are aware of his position.
If everybody knows Krishna to be God, then...It would be difficult for Krishna to repay his debt to the Brijbasi people.
如果在 Vrindavan 的人们，假设他们要知道了 Krishna 就是神的话，那么 Krishna 就难以，回报这些人。
He wouldn't be able to give them this highest ecstasy.
那 Krishna 就不可能。给予这些 Braja 的居民们以最高的灵性的喜乐。
Just like in the heavenly planets, he cannot give the people there this great ecstasy which the people in Vrindavan get.
就像在天堂 ，Krishna 就不可能给予他们，就像他给予 Vrindavan 居民们那么多的那么高的狂喜。
So by Krishna's inconceivable potencies, devotees who are dedicated to him, they lose all their attachment to material things.
即着 Krishna 不可思议的能量，他的奉献者们就失去了对一切物质事物的依恋。
They give up the cause of their delusion is their family and the attachment for the family and the affection for the family members. So they give these things up.
他们的虚幻幻觉是源于对家人的依附， 但是他们现在都一并了，一并已放弃了。
So by the association with Krishna, material life is finished.
由于他们跟 Krishna 的联谊，他们的物质生活也结束了。
And for Brahma tells Krishna that for certain devotees, you create a special illusion.To increase their attachment and desire.
Brahma 就告诉 Krishna, 对于特定的奉献者们 ,Krishna 增加了他们的依附心，增加了他们的物质欲望。
Brahma tells Krishna, you're capable of doing anything.
主 Brahma 就告诉主 Krishna,说你是无所不能的。
And you expand the ecstasy of your devotees on earth, which is something you could never do in Vaikuntha.
他说，您扩展了您在地球上这些奉献者们的狂喜之情，而这一点是您在Vaikuntha都不会做到，都不会去这么做的。
So Krishna's devotees who are fully surrendered, they accept all of their worldly, all the things they have in the material world, they accept it as his Mahaprasadam.
那在Krishna 已经臣服了的奉献者们，他们把物质世界的一切，把物质世界都接受为是 Krishna 的 Mahaprasadam。Krishna 的觊觎
and they think that their attachments are only for Krishna's sake.
他们认为他们的所有的依附仅仅是为了 Krishna 才产生依附的。
So their possessions and their attachments that allows them to feel some sweetness and feel some pleasure in their devotional service. And it helps to increase their spiritual life.
他们帮助他们增加扩展了他们的灵性生活。
And so there's nothing Krishna can do for these devotees. They're so elevated.
所以对于这种奉献者 ,Krishna 是无计可施，因为他们太进步了。
So Krishna has to remain in debt to them.
那么 Krishna 只能继续保持一个就是欠债者的身份。
Then Brahma prays to Krishna. He said, "There are people who say, I know everything about Krishna."
Krishna, Brahma 进步向 Krishna 祈祷说，有的人他们也许会自称。他们了解了 Krishna 的方方面面。
So Brahma says, let them think like that.
Brahma 说，就让他们那么想好了。
But for me, I do not wish to speak very much about this.
主 Brahma 说，但是对于我而言，我对此不想多说什么。
Brahma said, all I will say is that as far as your opulences are concerned, they are all beyond the reach of our body, mind, and words.
Brahma 说，就是涉及到您的富裕，那么他们，您的富裕是远远超越了我们的躯体心意。和言语的范畴。
So Brahma's prayer could be understood in three different ways.
可以 以三种不同的方式来理解 Brahma 的祈祷。
First of all, he's saying about the jnana is not very important compared to bhakti. Bhakti is much more important than jnana.
第一就是，比 jnana 思辨并不如奉爱那么重要。换言之，也就是奉爱要比思辨要重要。
And then the second thing is that he begins his prayers focusing on the supreme, on the form of the Lord, the transcendental form of the Lord.
那第二个理解就是，主 Brahma 的祈祷源于他描述主超然的形体之美。
But as the prayer goes on, then he becomes doubtful. He has some doubts about.What's actually the position?
当主 Brahma 进一步向 Krishna 献上祈祷的时候，这时候他内心反而升起了疑惑。
But then at the end, then he returns and he's convinced that glorifying Krishna's opulence is the greatest thing.
就 Brahma.就对于 Krishna 的真实身份反而产生了怀疑。那么随着进一步的祈祷，他对于 Krishna 的富裕就产生了坚定的信心。
And the third way we can understand it is that Brahma is laughing at those who think they know the glories of Krishna.
那么第三个结论就是 ，Brahma 他嘲笑那些自以为已经了解了主 Krishna 荣耀的人们。
Because the glories of Krishna and the people of Vrindavan are so big, it's like a huge ocean. You can never know everything.
因为 Krishna 和 Vrindavan 的居民的荣耀，就像浩瀚无垠的大海一样，深不可测，无边无际。
So in the first reason, Brahma is telling these people who are just interested in knowledge that they've not got the proper focus.
那首先 ，Brahma 就告诉这些专注于思辨的人们，告诉他们他们的这个焦点是不正确的。
But at the same time, he doesn't want to argue with them, and he doesn't want to waste his time proving to them that bhakti is more important.
其后 ，Brahma 也不想跟这些人争辩，告诉他们的思辨是浪费时间，而且思辨并不如奉爱来的那么重要。
But he wants to tell them that the glories of devotion to Krishna is far beyond the body and the mind and words.
Brahma 想告诉这些人，奉爱服务的荣耀是远远超越了身体、心意和言语的。
And that knowledge which they're pursuing, they're trying to cultivate this knowledge that it's very limited value compared to devotion.
他们企图培养的知识，其价值远远低于奉爱的价值。
And then in the second understanding of Brahma's prayer, the idea is that Krishna has appeared as the perfection of all beauty.
第二个从 Brahma 的祈祷文当中可以得出的第二个结论就是说 ，Krishna 的形象，它是所有美丽的巅峰。
And all of the qualities which are attractive.Nobody in the material world can equal Krishna.
在物质世界那些吸引人的特质都无法跟 Krishna 的俊美相媲美。
So Krishna's opulences, Krishna's qualities cannot be described even by the words of Brahma.
Krishna 的富裕 ，Krishna 的品质 ，Brahma 是难以形容了。
And just as Krishna's mind and words are beyond our understanding, so also are Krishna's physical activities. And then the third understanding is about Brahma's prayer, because Brahma often glorifies the people of Vrindavan. So here also he is glorifying their opulences, the people of Vrindavan.
那从 Brahma 的祈祷文当中 得出的第三个结论就是说，正像 Brahma 他总是在荣耀温达文的居民们，同样的就是温达文居民他们的富裕，也是超乎人们想象力的。
So Brahma composes he composes the words of the Vedic literature, but he cannot understand. He's not able to compose words to describe the greatness of the Brijbasi people.
主 Brahma 虽然是所有伟达文献的编纂者，但是他却对于这些 Braja 居民们的富裕和地位，主 Brahma 他现在却说不，他现主 Brahma 却没有什么言语可以描述 Braja Basi 他们的荣耀和地位。
Brahma is the guna avatar. He's one of the guna avatars, you know, in charge of the mode of passion, because he has to do the work of creation. So he has a transcendental body and he has all potencies, but he's not able to describe these Brijbasi people.
Brahma, Guna Avatar 之一，是品质化身之一，他是激情属性的化身，因为他负责创造，他有拥有着超人的身体，还有着不可思议的力量，但是轮到 Brahma 描述 Braja 居民的荣耀的时候， Brahma 他却没有足够的话语来描述这些 Braja 居民的
Yeah, his body, mind, and words are not enough to describe these Brijbasi people.
当形容这些 Braja 居民的地位和荣耀的时候，主 Brahma 他没有充足的，他的体力、他的心意、他的话语都不足以来描述 Braja 居民的荣耀。
So now Brahma prays to Krishna, he said, I request your permission to leave.
接下来 Brahma 就向 Krishna 祈祷说，我现在想希望得到您的允许，我现在要告辞了。
Brahma says, you can see everything, you are the Lord of the whole, you're the Lord.Of all the universes, but I offer this one universe to you.
主 Brahma 说，他对 Krishna 说，您能看到一切，而且您是所有宇宙的主人。现在我把我的这个宇宙供奉给您。
So Brahma's prayers have allowed him to get the mercy of the Lord by offering his prayers to Krishna.He's been able to get Krishna's mercy, which has taken away his pride in thinking himself to be the Lord of the universe.
Brahma 就通过他的祈向主的祈祷，就得到了主 Krishna 的仁慈。主 Krishna 就拿走了他的骄傲。原来主 Brahma 以为自己是宇宙之主。
So Brahma considers himself not fit to stay very close to the Brijbasi people.
Brahma 他认为自己不适合，就是太靠近这些 Braja 的居民们。
He's afraid he might commit more offenses, so he asks permission if he can leave to go to his home.
主 Brahma 担心他会进一步做出更多的冒犯，所以他现在请求 Krishna 允许他离开，让他回家。
So Krishna knows everything. He knows about his own greatness, and he also knows about the fallen condition of people like Brahma.
Krishna 无所不知，他知道了解一切。他知道他自己的自身的伟大，他也了解了 Brahma 的堕落的地位。
So Brahma is asking permission from Krishna. He's asking to leave because he knows he doesn't have the ability to offer proper prayers to Krishna.
Brahma 现在就恳求 Krishna 允许他离开，因为他已经没有能力再做出祈祷了。
So,The Acharyas explain that this verse could also be understood to be a reply of Brahma to a request from Krishna.
Acharya 们先辈 Acharya 们领导师们说评论说这个诗节也可以这样来看待这个诗节。
The,
这个诗节是就 Krishna 对于 Brahma 的一个祈祷的一个回复。
That Krishna is asking Brahma to describe more about the glories of Krishna's beauty and about the qualities of devotional service to him and for his devotees also who live in Vrindavan.Krishna wants Brahma to describe the glories of Krishna himself and also of the Vrindavan people.
Krishna 他请求 Brahma 来描述，他自己自身以及 Vrindavan 的人们他们的荣耀。
So Brahma is astonished, would be astonished to hear this from Krishna.And he would ask if Krishna really knows everything about his own glories or not.
Brahma 对 Krishna 这个请求会感到惊讶，因为 Brahma 会向问 Krishna 他自己，他是否自己已经了解了他自身的荣耀，已经充分了解了这个荣耀。
Because Krishna is supposed to be omniscient, he's supposed to know everything, so doesn't he know about his own glories? Will he know his own glories in full?
Krishna 本来Krishna 呢理应当是无所不知的，那难道 Krishna 不能彻头彻尾的了解他自己的荣耀了吗？
Or another way to understand the verse is thatKrishna wants to know why Brahma wants to leave, because Brahma had just prayed that he would like to take any birth in Vrindavan. So why doesn't he just simply stay?
Krishna 他想要了解为什么 Brahma 他现在要恳求离开呢？那他不是祈祷说他想要在 Vrindavan 以任何形式出生吗？那为什么他现在要请求离开这里呢？
Krishna is very happy to hear Brahma describe about the glories of Vrindavan, So he's thinking, why don't you just stay and tell me more about Vrindavan?
当 Krishna 听到 Brahma 形容了 Vrindavan 的荣耀之后，他内心非常快乐。那 Krishna 就想，为什么你不能留下来继续来荣耀 Vrindavan 呢？
But Brahma answers that, you know, Krishna knows everything, so he knows also how difficult it is for Brahma with his four heads to stay in Vrindavan.
那作为回应呢 ，Brahma 就，就说 Krishna 他应该是了解一切的，那他也应该了解 Brahma 他现在是以四头形象，他这种形象难以留在 Vrindavan.
Difficult for him to change his body. He has to wait for the end of his life, of the life of Brahma. Then at that time, then he can change his body.
那对于 Krishna, 他应该理解 Brahma, 他很难改变自己的模样，他得等到自己这一世结束之后才能改变他的模样。
So Krishna knows that in this present life, Brahma won't be able to get the dust from the residents of Vrindavan's feet.
Krishna 知道，在 Brahma 的这一世，他很难得到 Vrindavan 居民他们足下的尘土。
And Krishna also knows how embarrassing it would be for Brahma to try to describe the greatness of these devotees.
Krishna 也知道，对于 Brahma 来说呢，他很难就是充分的形容这些奉献者的伟大。Brahma 呢，他做要想做到这点，他是自愧弗如。
Yeah, Brahma feels Brahma is not fit. He's not fit to be able to describe these people because their position is so elevated.
Brahma 不适合来描述这些奉献者们的伟大，因为他们太进步了。
And Krishna has so much debt to the Brijbasi people; he's totally under their control.
而且 Krishna 他深深亏欠这些 Braj 居民们，而且他完全是处在他们的控制之下了。
And he's so attracted by their devotion that Krishna doesn't like to spend a moment away from them.
Krishna 深深受到他们奉爱的吸引，片刻也不能离开他们。
So Krishna knows all this. So why should Brahma stay? Brahma's saying to Krishna, Krishna knows everything about the people of Vrindavan. So what's the point of Brahma staying just to tell Krishna what he already knows?
Brahma 就想。Krishna 他对于 Vrindavan 居民的地位已经心知肚明了，为什么他还要要求 Brahma 自己留下来继续描述他们的荣耀呢？
And Krishna could also say, why did Brahma put prayers like this? Why he put prayers without considering what he was asking for?And Brahma is the creator of the universe, so he should know everything about the universe.
而且 Brahma 作为宇宙的创造者，应该对这个宇宙的每个细枝末节都应该了如指掌呢。
But Brahma says, no, only Krishna is omniscient, only Krishna knows everything.
那 Brahma 他会矢口否定，不是的。只有 Krishna 才是无所不知的。
Brahma says, my knowledge is limited.
Brahma 会说我的知识太有限了。
So Brahma prayed Brahma praise is inspired by Krishna from the heart. Krishna is the Lord of the heart. So Brahma's prayer was inspired by Krishna.
Krishna 是内心的主人，所以 Brahma 现在的祈祷也是内心的主 Krishna 所激发的。
So any credit for the prayers goes to Krishna.
所以如果 Brahma 的这些祈祷文有任何的成就的话，那这些成就一切荣耀都归 Krishna.
And if there's anything wrong with the prayers, then it's not Brahma says it's not my fault.I shouldn't get the blame.
而如果他 Brahma 这段祈祷文有任何错误的话 ，Brahma 说那也不是我的错误，也不应该归咎于我。
So Krishna may say, Krishna would respond saying, "Well, Brahma is more than just a servant. Brahma is the Lord of the universe."
那 Krishna 又会反唇相讥。Brahma 他的地位可不只是仆人的地位，他可是宇宙之主啊。
But Brahma says no. He said, Krishna, you're Jagannath, you're the Lord of the universe, not me.
然后 Brahma 又会反唇相讥说不，你是 Jagannath 的，你才是宇宙之主呢。
Well, Krishna may say, well, who me? I'm the Lord of the universe.You're the grandsire of the entire cosmos and its ruler. All its rulers are your sons and grandsons and your descendants. So how can you be my servant? You're the head, everyone came from you.
Krishna, 他可能又会又会回答 Brahma 说，那个这个宇宙，你是宇宙的祖父，你是宇宙的统治者，所有的这些居民们都是你的儿孙后代，你怎么是仆人呢？你实际上是整个宇宙的领袖，是宇宙的头啊。
But Brahma answers this. He says, "Well, the whole universe is within you. The whole creation is under you."
Brahma 反而又会说，对 Krishna 说，整个的宇宙都在你的体内，整个的创造都来自于你。
Brahma said, "You put the universe under my authority, but you're the above me."
Brahma 会说，虽然你让我当了宇宙的权威，但是你在我之上啊。
So even if Krishna admits that he's the Lord of the universe and everyone is his servant, why did Brahma condemn non-devotees?
那么 Krishna 就会承认，他是宇宙的主人，其他的都是他的仆人。那现在 Brahma 为什么要谴责那些非奉献者呢？
And why does Brahma praise the devotees? And why does Brahma beg to become one of the Lord's servants?
为什么 Brahma 要赞美那些奉献者 ？Brahma 要恳求成为仆人呢
？And why did he pray to take a birth in Vrindavan?
Brahma 为什么要祈祷投生在 Vrindavan 呢
？Yeah, what difference should it all make to Brahma?If everyone in the universe is already a servant of Krishna.
那么既然宇宙当中所有的生物都是 Krishna 的仆人，那对于 Brahma 来说呢，这一切又有什么区分呢？
Everybody is a servant of yours. Everyone is naturally under your control, a servant.But some serve you with pure love, and they have special devotion.
宇宙当中的每一个众生，天生都是仆人，都在主的控制之下。但有的生物体，他们内心怀着纯爱，怀着特殊的奉爱。
And so that service with pure love is not. It's very rare. And it's only possible with complete surrender.
那份纯爱发自内心的纯粹的奉爱做出的服务是非常罕见的，只有已经全然臣服了的人才能做出这种奉爱。
So in this mood, Brahma offers the universe which he thinks to be his own and which he considers himself, which he considers the body, he offers it to Krishna.
Brahma, 现在他就把这个宇宙，他认为是自己身体的这个宇宙，现在他供奉给了 Krishna。
So Lord Krishna is actually Jagannath, and everything is known to him, and that Lord has directed Brahma from within his heart. So Brahma's position is like a little bird which chews what the mother has already chewed.
Brahma 的地位就好像是一只小鸟一样，他现在吞咽的是他母亲已经咀嚼过之后放到他口中的食物。
And in this way he's offering it to Krishna, and he prays that Krishna will accept it and forgive him for requesting something impossible.
Brahma 就把这又供奉给 Krishna， 恳求 Krishna 予以接受，并且原谅他去向 Krishna 曾经做出了对他来说不可能的请求。
Okay, so we'll stop.
好，我们讲课部分就停到这里。
Are there any questions?
Yes, some questions. 第一个是来自于 Das， Krishna 的焦虑与我们的焦虑有什么区别呢？ What is the difference between Krishna's anxiety and our anxiety?
Well, Krishna's anxiety is transcendental. Our anxiety is material.
区别就是 Krishna 的焦虑是超然的，我们的焦虑是物质的。
Krishna's anxiety is for our well-being. Our anxiety is for our sense gratification.
Krishna 的焦虑是出于对我们的福祉的考虑，而我们的焦虑呢，是出于我们自身的感官享乐的考虑。
Yeah.
第二个问题是，继续来自于 Das， 老师都说服务快变快乐，为什么我念诵没有感觉到快乐？Question mark in
okay.
this one question.
All right. So why are you not feeling happy when you chant Hare Krishna?
It is said that the service brings happiness, but when I chant, I didn't feel happiness. And when I preach, I didn't feel happiness. And when I worship the Gurunitai deity, that small doll of Gurunitai, and I don't feel happiness. And when I serve devotee, I didn't feel happiness. And when I honor Prasadam, I feel a little happiness. So what's the wrong? What's the wrong with this?
I think you don't know what real happiness is.
那我认为就是你并不了解真正的快乐是什么。
If you actually understood what happiness is, you would know you were actually happy. You're thinking happiness just to be something in your senses, but happiness is much more than that.
如果你了解了什么是真实的快乐，你就明白了。你现在呢？你觉得快乐是来自于感官的， 但是快乐是远远高于感官得到的快乐。
It's often we don't understand what is real happiness. We're thinking, you know, when you're actually, we're thinking happiness is just no suffering. We don't know. Real happiness is something which we experience through the soul.
我们对于快乐并不了解快乐。我们认为快乐就是没有痛苦就快乐，但实际上呢，快乐它是源于灵魂的快乐。
Just like, you know, we're thinking, oh, it's so hot. If we put an air conditioner in, we'll make the room cool, we'll feel happy. That's not real happiness.
就是在炎热的天气夏季呢，我们觉得非常闷热，然后我们觉得打开空调啊，那我就快乐了。但实际上，真正快乐是不止这一点的。
So you have to understand, happiness is not just something which is perceived by the senses. You like you eat prasadam, you feel happy, your tongue feels happy.
那您要理解的就是说，快乐，它不仅仅是感官上的快乐。那您荣耀菩萨的时候，您感觉到一点快乐，来自于舌尖的快乐。
But the real happiness is an awakening of spiritual consciousness.
真实的快乐是来源于灵性知觉的唤醒。
You have to be patient. You've experienced happiness. At least by doing devotional service, you should appreciate you're not experiencing suffering.
现在呢，您就要有耐心。至少您应该理解这一点，就是当您做奉献服务的时候呢，现在您就是没有，您并没有在体验着痛苦的。
When you chant Hare Krishna, when you serve the deities, and when you do devotional service, you're not experiencing any suffering.
那现在呢，当您已经开始念诵哈尔克什了，并且崇拜着快乐娃娃，从事奉献服务的时候，您在做这些事情的当下就并没有在体验着痛苦。
So you should feel happy for that.
那您就对此就应该感到心满意足了，知足。
OK.
Next one, 下一个。下一个是来自于 Sati. Sati is asking this Prabhu, how long have you been doing service? Okay, next is from Shruti Rupa Devadasi. Hare Krishna, 顶拜老师 Guru. 最近遇到一些问题，请教 Guru 信士祝福。第一，遇到一些已经深入佛法经典多年修行的人，他们也愿意谦虚地学习不再犯歌，但是会拿很多佛经来套 Krishna 说的话，就像我当年一样，请教 Guru， 我现在应该怎么帮助他们稳定的进入 Krishna 知觉呢？ So the first question from Shruti Rupa Devadasi is that she paid obeisance to you and teachers, and now she asked to get some blessing and instruction from you. First, now there are some Buddhistwho have studied the Buddhist sutra for many years and practice Buddhism for many years, and now they are willing to humbly learn Bhagavad Gita, but sometimes they will quote this sutra shloka from Buddhist scripture and to compare with the words with spoken by Krishna. Just like I am myself in the beginning. So Guru, how can I help them to enter into Krishna consciousness steadily?
Well, you have to explain to them the importance of chanting Hare Krishna. They have to chant the Hare Krishna mantra. They have to hear the holy name of Krishna, and that will help them to awaken spiritual consciousness.
通过这种方法唤醒他们的灵性的知觉。
You have to also point out to them that when we're chanting Hare Krishna, that we're not chanting Hare Krishna to become Krishna, but we're chanting Hare Krishna as a service, to be the servant of Krishna. Because Buddhists always think the goal is to become the Buddha, so these people may think we're trying to become Krishna. But you have to explain to them that we're always the servant of Krishna.
Next one?
Yeah. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna.
Yes, I'm here.
Yeah, so do you want to say more about this question?
No.
Oh, 那我们看下一个。我现在发现自己很容易受外界的影响，着急。 比如说看妈妈喜欢吃肉。 玩手机，请问Guru怎么才让自己内心保持平静耐心呢？ I found myself very, sometimes I feel a little bit in a rush, because I'm easily influenced by the others. For example, when I saw my mother likes to eat meat and also like to look on her cell phone. So Guru, how can I make myself very peaceful, always peaceful and have patience?
Yes, put down your handphone, turn it off, and pick up your big bag and start to chant.
Because Shruti Rupa's mother, her mother still likes to eat meat and likes to see the cell phone. So she felt she's a little bit worried. So she wants to not be so influenced by her mother's condition and still very peaceful in her own mind.
Yes. Well, maybe you have to show an example to your mother. Show her how to be detached from everything by putting away your handphone and just chanting Hare Krishna.
您呐，要给您的妈妈做榜样，就是表现出这种不依附，您自己就得把手机放下来，然后总是念诵 Hare Krishna。
Your mother likes to eat meat. You should tell her that you like animals. Ask your mother, does she not like animals? Does she like to go and see the animals being killed? Does she think Buddha would like to see the animals being killed?
那您妈妈喜欢吃肉，那您就得告诉您妈妈，就是说您自己就是特别喜爱动物，那您得问她，难道您不喜欢那些小动物？您喜欢看到，您忍心看到那些小动物被杀戮吗？佛祖他可是不忍心看到众生被杀死的呀。
You have to also be a good cook. You have to cook very nicely to attract your mother to want to taste your food.
您现在就得下功夫，自己就做一个一流的厨师，然后给您妈妈做这个好吃的食物，吸引她的味蕾，让您妈妈特别喜欢吃您，品尝您做的食物。
So you have to understand your mother also is older and senior to you, so it will be very difficult for you to convince her.
有一点您得明白，因为您妈妈上了岁数了，而且又比您资格老，所以要说服她改动改变她是有点难度的。
So, don't expect to change her, but at least she should appreciate that what you're doing is good, something good.
那您就不要对期待您的母亲改变她。只要他能欣赏您做了的，您的做法，认为您的做法是非常好的就行了。
You have to convince her that you're getting a higher, a greater pleasure, a greater satisfaction from chanting Hare Krishna. That you've become detached, you've become free from all the pressure and stress of the material world, and you're so detached, you're able to put down your handphone and you just want to chant Hare Krishna.
你要说服你妈妈一点，就是说您现在特别的高兴，特别快乐，特别念诵 Hare Krishna 感到很满足，您已经没有那些依附了，而且您已经摆脱了焦虑、紧张、压力这些情绪，负面情绪，所以就是您自己呢，就不喜欢老盯着手机看，您就喜欢念诵 Hare Krishna。
OK。
下一个第三个，为什么阿朱那的母亲总是祈祷 Krishna 给他更多磨难考试？这是一种什么样的心态？对于我们应该学习他哪些方面的品质呢？ So Krishna's Arjuna's mother, Kunti, she's always praying to Krishna to give her more trouble and tests. So what kind of mood is this? For us, what kind of can we learn from her? What qualities can we learn from her?And in what respect can we learn from her?
Well, Queen Kunti's telling us that when she's in difficulty, she remembers Krishna more. It's easier for her to remember Krishna when she's in difficulties.
Kunti 王后她就告诉我们，就是说当她处在困难当中，她更能想起 Krishna。更容易能记起 Krishna。
Just like when we're in danger, when we're in trouble, we have then who do we turn to? A devotee will turn to Krishna for help. We'll pray to Krishna, save me.
们遇到危险、遇到麻烦的时候，那我们应该把脸转向谁呢？奉献者呢，他们就会转向慧士呢，祈祷慧士呢，救救我。
When we have money, we want to enjoy our money. But when we lose our money, then we pray to Krishna. Oh, Krishna, give me money.
我们自己有钱了，然后我们就想享受。那当我们这个钱丢了的时候，我们就向 Krishna 祈祷， Krishna, 快给我点钱，让我找回来吧。
There was an incident took place, one big temple, and all the devotees were in the temple, and then the ground started to shake, and the building started to shake, and there was going to be an earthquake, so they told everyone to go outside.
有这么一件事情，就在一个大庙里头，然后里头有很多奉献者。这时候大地突然开始摇晃了，然后这个庙的墙体也都开始晃动，马上地震就发生了。这时候呢，他们就要求这些庙里的人赶紧撤离。
So everybody rushed outside, they all got outside, and they were all outside chanting. And they said it was that night when they were out there chanting, they said that was the best chanting they ever did in their life.
然后庙里的所有的人都冲了出去，然后他们就在这一晚上，他们就开始念诵，不由自主的就开始念诵。他们后来回忆说，这一晚上的念诵是他们这一辈子念诵最佳的效果，最佳的念诵了。
So Queen Kunti's prayer is also appropriate, that she knows when she's in difficulty, she will turn to Krishna.
昆蒂王后的祈祷是非常恰当的，这就表明了当一个人处在困境当中的时候，应当向谁去寻求帮助？他是向 Krishna 寻求帮助。
下
一个，下个问题是来自于 Yuna Hare Krishna Guru Maharaj, please accept my humble obeisances. It is considered that we should serve Krishna in a situation in which we are at the moment. But if I want to move to a city where there is an ISKCON temple, can I meditate on that? And will it be a material desire? 下一个问题来自于 Yuna Hare Krishna Guru Maharaj, 请接受我卑微顶拜。一般来说，就是我们应当是临在当下来服务 Krishna。可是，如果我想搬到一所有伊斯坎庙宇的城市，我能不能就是现在冥想这种情况呢？那这个会不会算一种物质欲望呢
？No, it's not a material desire. It's a desire for your spiritual benefit, so that you can increase and improve your devotional service.So it's not material.
这不是物质的欲望。通常来说，我们会为了我们的这也会有利于您的灵性的好处，增加您的灵性，也会对我们的奉献服务有好处，不是物质欲望。
So we hope you can soon move.We hope Krishna will hear your prayer and help you get relocated to a city where there's a Krishna conscious center.
We hope Krishna will hear your prayer and help you get relocated to a city where there's a Krishna conscious center.
Okay.
Thank
you. Okay.
主持人，所有奉献者 ，Brahma 冒犯文达文的居民，也冒犯了主 Krishna。他是最有智慧的第一位生物，为什么做出了冒犯呢 ？Panchatattva Prabhu said, obeisances my host and all devotee. Lord Brahma offended the residents of Vrindavan and also offended Lord Krishna. Yet he is the first progenitor of the universe and most, he's the most wise person. He has wisdom. But why did he make this offense?
Well, we could say it was a pastime. It was the arrangement of Lord Krishna. Lord Krishna wants to show that how Maya is so strong that even if you're in the position of Lord Brahma, you can become influenced by Maya.
You can say this is a Krishna's安排。主 Krishna通过这个消时光，就表明Maya假象的力量是多么强大。
Right, that Lord, sometimes Krishna arranges these pastimes, he puts different devotees into illusion, just like he put Arjuna into illusion, that Arjuna didn't want to fight.
所以这个是Krishna安排。 Krishna安排主婆罗婆处在幻想当中，就好像 Krishna安排了Arjuna处在虚幻当中，使得Arjuna并不想作战。So
Krishna arranged to put Brahma into this illusion because Brahma is thinking that I'm the supreme, because he's in such a big position in the universe, so it's very easy for him to become proud. And to think that he is the most important person, and he will forget that he is actually the servant of the Supreme Lord.
Brahma, 婆罗婆摩呢，他会把自己放置在至尊的地位上，他很容易骄傲，所以呢，就对，就是很重要的一点是要让 Brahma。 记住他，不要忘记他是至尊主的仆人。Yeah,
we see Brahma is like some people, you know, some people think Brahma is the Lord of the universe. They think he's the supreme because they see everybody coming from him. He's the grandfather of all demigods and everyone. They're all coming from him. So people, all ordinary people, they think Brahma is actually the Supreme Lord and everything is from him, coming from him. And so they worship him. So Brahma sometimes he thinks it's true and he forgets that he's just simply a servant of Lord Krishna. Just like sometimes even somebody is a, they may become a spiritual teacher and they may start to think that they're actually the supreme, that they know everything, all the knowledge they're speaking, they think that they're very great. But they have to remember that everything they say is simply coming from their guru and coming from the parampara. That actually without the mercy of the guru, they're nothing.
就像有的时候，有的领导是认为他们是至尊的。 然后他们讲述他们的知识，使得他们变得非常伟大。他们忘记了，他们应当记住他们的知识是来自他们自己的灵性导师，来自于师徒传承的。没有他们自己灵性导师的仁慈，那他们是一无是处，他们什么也不是。And
ultimately, everything comes from Krishna. It's Krishna who's the source of all everything. We should therefore offer everything to him for his worship.
那终极而言，一切都来自于 Krishna，
Krishna 是万缘之源，所以我们当把一切都供奉给 Krishna， Krishna 是值得崇拜的。
But we don't see Krishna so easily. Krishna's hidden from us. And so in the absence of Krishna, we're thinking, I did it, I'm the doer, I'm the supreme.
但是 Krishna， 我们看不见 Krishna， Krishna 把自己给隐藏起来了。然后在 Krishna 不在的情况下，我们看不见的情况下，我们就认为是我做的这件事，我是至尊。
因为冒犯他没有祈祷的力量了吗？ So because of this offense, Lord Brahma, didn't have the power to offer a prayer.
Well, now the point there is that it wasn't so much because of his offense, it's just that the position of these devotees, the Brijbasi people, that they're the eternal associates of Lord Krishna, they're the very great devotees, and they're like from the spiritual world, and they've come with Krishna to take part in his pastimes. And Lord Brahma, he's just becoming, he's on the path to perfection. But these people in Vrindavan, they're already perfect. So he, you know, he, and these people are so, they're so far above the position of Lord Brahma that it's very hard for Brahma to understand them and to praise them. Because the Lord you did not read the whole thing. Because the Lord what?
Because the Lord says he is completely satisfied himself, and also Krishna may not physically be present in Vrindavan, but he is there at all times. Gurudev, please clarify me on this. Hare Krishna Gurudev, 请接受卑微顶拜。我对此不清楚。Brahma 认为 Krishna 感到不完整，或者是有分离的感觉。当主离开了 Vrindavan 的奉献者，主感觉到就是有缺憾，或者是还是主真的是感觉到分离呢？因为主说他已经是完全自足的了，而且 Krishna， 他虽然是外在的，并不在 Vrindavan， 可他总是在 Vrindavan， 他总是一直在 Vrindavan 呢。Gurudev， 请向我澄清这一点。
Yes, Krishna is always in Vrindavan, but sometimes he's manifest and sometimes he's not.
是的 ，Krishna 他总在 Vrindavan， 但是他有的时候展示，但有的时候是不展示的状态。
So Krishna manifests himself in the hearts of the gopis. He's there in the hearts of the gopis, but his physical presence, or at least his transcendental form being manifest in Vrindavan, was only there for some time, and after some time he left Vrindavan. But as you say, he never leaves. So where did he go? He hid himself in the hearts of the gopis.
Krishna 是在勾皮们的心中展示。虽然就是 Krishna 他外在的有的时候展示出他超人的形象，但是呢 ，Krishna 有的时候呢，他后来他就离开了本达文。虽然就是 Krishna 其实他永远不离开本达文。那个时候呢 ，Krishna 是把自己躲在了勾皮们的心中了。
When Krishna does feel separation from his devotees, in the form of Jagannath, Baladeva and Subhadra, with their arms and legs shrunk into their bodies and their eyes dilated, with their eyes expanded large, this is a sign of their feeling of separation from the devotees.
而且 Krishna 确实感受到了分离之情。Krishna 展示为 Jagannath 的 Baladeva Subhadra 这个形象的时候呢，这三尊神祇他们的四肢就收回，已经缩回了他们的就是躯干，然后他们眼睛就睁得大大的，已经就是睁得圆圆的。这时候的这种形象，实际上就是他们感受到奉献者的分离之情的时候展示出来的。
So devotees, we experience separation from Krishna, and Krishna, how can we experience separation from Krishna? It's because that feeling of separation is also there in Krishna, that Krishna feels separation from his devotees. So everything which is there within us is also there is in Krishna.
Okay.
Yes, is that all right, Yogita? Yeah? Anyway, if it's not, she can ask more.
那么这位奉献者，如果 Yogita Sharma 如果没有回答您的问题，您可以再进一步提问。下一个问题，我们看一下是来自求真。
求真，
顶拜咕噜，您好，为什么不能称自己的 Guru Maharaj？我想他应该是不能直接直呼其名吧。So this devotee said that obeisance guru, why we cannot directly call the name of our Guru Maharaj?
Why we cannot directly call the name of our Guru Maharaj?
Because this is not very clear in myself.She said, why can't we 不能称自己的歌吗？ I'll ask this devotee to further clarify the question. So can we move to the next question?
Okay.
She said, yes.Yes, 他说的不是，就是称自己的 guru 的时候，为什么不能带着 Maharaj? She said, this devotee said that when we call our guru, why can't we call add Maharaj to the name of our own guru?
Well, you can.
可以。
Many people call their spiritual master as Guru Maharaj.
许多奉献者就称他们自己的 Guru 是 Guru Maharaj.
Maharaj means one who is the king of the senses. So the spiritual master is supposed to be controller of the senses.
Maharaj 的这个梵文词的意思是感官之主，所以灵性导师们他们已经控制了他们的感官了。下一个问题是来自于文言，顶拜咕噜，薄伽梵歌说灵魂不生不灭，灵魂是从哪里来的呢？ So this is Guru.But I think they said the soul is eternal. There's no birth and no death. But where does the soul come from?
Well, soul is a part of Krishna. With Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says, Mami Vamsa Jiva Loke Jiva Bhuta Sanatana, that the living entities are all eternally my parts and partials. So we're a part of Krishna. We're from the partial. Right? We're coming from Krishna. Everything comes from Krishna. We also come from Krishna.
Bhajan Fan Ge, we are Krishna's part. Bhajan Fan Ge 就说了，在这个物质世界的众生都是我永恒的碎片部分。然后，因为我Bhajan Fan Ge说我们都是 Krishna 的所属部分，所以一切我们是来自 Krishna 的。而且一切都是来自于 Krishna 的，我们也是来自 Krishna 的。
Of course, we're very small. Krishna's very great. We're like little sparks, and Krishna's like the big fire. So from the fire, many sparks may come. The spark also has heat and light. So we have the qualities of Krishna, but not in the same quantity.
我们特别渺小，但 Krishna 是非常伟大的。我们就好像火星，Krishna 就好像一团大熊熊的大火，然后就我们就像这些小火星，我们也有热量，我们也有光芒，但是我们在质上是跟 Krishna 同一，但是在量上不一样。下一个问题。依然，明白咕噜，请问面对疫情去做志愿者，有的甚至死亡，从奉献角度怎么看待这件事？ Obviously, Guru, in the situation of the COVID-19, somebody has volunteered to do service, but some died. So how can we see this situation from the point of devotional service?From the point of devotion?
Well, we have to understand the nature of the material world. That in the material world there is birth, there is also death. It's not that because of COVID people died. People are always dying. Dying is always going on. At the same time, birth is also taking place. People are taking birth. So birth and death are the nature of this material world.It's not just to do with COVID, but it's the nature of material life.
This is the 物质世界的本性。物质世界就是一个生死的地方。人们不是因为就是新冠病毒而死亡。在这期间也有人出生，也有人死亡。就是物质世界就是一个生死的地方。所以物质世界的本性就是这样的。Sorry, Maharaj, she asked that, she said that somebody who is very kind-hearted and who is, who volunteered, 志愿者, who volunteered to do some good things, beneficial things,I guess to help the patients or help with the medical care, but who died also.
Yes, yes, sometimes it happens. People, they have good intentions, they want to do something good, but in the course of their efforts, they may die. And so we should understand the material world is like that. It's a place of birth and death. We all have to die. You shouldn't think that just because we're doing something good that we shouldn't die. We live by the grace of Krishna and we die by the grace of Krishna. Of course, we don't really die, the soul doesn't die, but we give up one body, we go and take another body. And so when somebody who is doing devotion, trying to do something like that, we should understand that Krishna took them away to go and do something more important in another place.
会发生这种事情，但是我们明白，物质世界就是这样，物质世界就会有生有死，我们都会死，并不是说人们做了好事就不死了，人们因为Krishna的仁慈活着，也因为Krishna的仁慈死去，灵魂永远不生不灭，只是躯体变化而已。他们做了志愿者，然后死去了，是Krishna把他们带走。 然后让他们去从事另外一个更重要的事情，去了另外一个地方。
Yes, very good. And now, 明白吗？
好。
Okay, 继续，还有问题吗？
潘智大爸， Prabhupada, Yogita Sham says, thank you so much for this heart-touching, perfect answer. Pandava said, thank you for your mercy, dear Maharaj. Yes, and that devotee who asked the question that we shouldn't add Maharaj to our guru's name, it is told by our senior devotees. Okay, that's all.
没有别的问题。 没有了，萨提没有了吧？OK，今天我们结束，我们感谢，Guru Mani Madhiji给我们真谛的翻译，感谢萨提主持，我们感谢所有的奉献者聆听提问，祝福你们长诵快乐，铃声的进步，Hare Krishna，Srila Prabhupada ki jai。
百坤的清音福缘听，我们非常非常感谢圣巴迪维根的美娜什纳辛。